energy balance or the reactive system. I think this is the final lecture on the energy balance for the steady state. That's right. Okay. For this case, I will show you an example for do the energy balance for the reaction system. Now, also the same technique. The first step, you have to draw the flow chart and label on the flow chart. That's like what is you know, the label condition, the label the mass of input, mass of output, or initial state or final state. And the next step, you have to check material balance and phase equation, phase equilibrium. You have to check mass is balanced or not. That's right. If it's not balanced, you have to determine the mass balance and have to check the phase equilibrium for single system or multiple system. And the next step, you have to choose the reference state. And then you prepare the inlet, outlet, entropy, or internal energy as I showed you in the previous example for energy balance for non-reactive system. Then you calculate or solve the equation based on energy balance and material balance. We have two techniques for the energy balance or reactive process. The first technique, we use the energy balance that related to reaction. Heat of reaction, you can calculate based on heat of reaction method. The second method, you calculate based on heat of formation method. Right? You have two techniques. You calculate based on heat of formation and calculate based on heat of reaction. Okay, we look at the first technique. Based on heat of reaction. I will talk this technique. I will follow the example like this for this method. That's right. This method is generally preferable when there is a single reaction. For a single reaction, you use the heat of reaction method. It's the easy way. You can use heat of formation also, but for the single method, the heat of reaction is recommended for you. Okay, we will follow this technique by this example. For this example, his reaction it should be combustion reaction because we have the furnace. That's right. Furnace, that means reaction at really high temperature or combustion reactor. For this case, we have some heat input to the furnace, Q. That's right. The reactant, we have propane, that's right, C3H6 gas. 100 mole at 25 Celsius. And also we feed air, that's like oxygen and nitrogen. That's like, I talk to you about the combustion reaction, why we feed air, not pure oxygen, based on the economic, that's like, based on the economic reason. For this case, we have a oxygen, it's 600 mole oxygen, and 2,265, 56 mole nitrogen per second. The temperature is 300 Celsius. They need to feed, we have to feed, that's right. Propane and air, feed to the furnace. And the product, we have oxygen, nitrogen, that's right. This unreact oxygen and unreact nitrogen. You can see that amount of nitrogen input and output the same. This is inert gas, no reaction for nitrogen, input equal to output. And product should be CO2 and water. This is the product. That's right. This is the chemical reaction. The chemical reaction, we check the carbon, hydrogen, oxygen is balanced already. Now. This is the atom, it's balanced. Three carbon. Eight hydrogen. 10 oxygen, okay. It's balanced. The heat of reaction is -2,220 kilojoule per mole. This is exothermic reaction, asthenic state. That's an asthenic state at 25 Celsius, 188. This is the heat of reaction. Okay. For the flow chart or diagram, you know the input condition, the output condition. The output at 100,000. That's right, 100,000. Okay. Okay, for the first step, you have to check the material balance. For this case, we check the material balance. We assume the steady state. That's right. We assume the steady state. Input, minus output, that's right, minus the consumption per generation. For this case, we check already. Is it balance already. That's right. Is it balance already for the mass balance? It's balance already. Okay. Mass is balance already. The next step, you have to do the energy balance. Before do the energy balance, you have to choose the reference state. That's right, the reference state to calculate the entropy. Sometimes you know oxygen, nitrogen gas, we have the table from table 8 I talked to you. If you reference in table 8, the reference state should be 25 Celsius or 188. That's right, or 188 for that case. I talk to you. This is attractive here. For gas state, that's right. Nitrogen, oxygen, CO2, and water, you can shoot at 25 1 TM at different state. But for propane, we have no data in table VF. That's right. The table VF, we have oxygen, carbon dioxide, water, and nitrogen. Okay, you can shoot the 25 Celsius, 1 ATM. As shown in table BA, but for propane, we have no data. That's right. We have no data. For that case, you can shoot the reference state at input or output. For this case, the best way we select input at the reference state at 25 Celsius. Okay. And finally, we get that the reference state of propane. It's the input at the reference state. That's right. And oxygen, nitrogen, CO2, water is 25 Celsius 188 also. But because the feed is 25 and 188. And also at turbine B8 is also 25 and 188. Okay, now you state the reference state. That's right, set the reference state. Again, for propane, we reference to feed. Or update, we reference to table B8. But for this case, the feed and table BS is the same, 25 and 180. That's right, 25 and 180 also. Okay, now you contract the reference state. Okay, the next step, you calculate the heat of reaction or exchange of reaction. That's right. For this case, it is a single reaction. Single reaction in a continuous process. That's right, continuous process, no accumulation. You can calculate the exchange of reaction from the propane out minus propane in divided by the absolute stoichiometry. I show you on the last week how to calculate the exchange operation. For this case, the output, there is no output of propane. That is the complete reaction. As I found, there is no propane output. That means all propane is react or complete reaction. As I complete reaction. Minus input divided by what? For this case, we use the absolute value. You get 100 mole per second. This is the exchange of reaction. That's like exchange of reaction. Okay. And then you prepare the table for energy balance. That's right. Okay, we have propane, oxygen, nitrogen, CO2, water. This is the inlet. This is the outlet. In, out. That's right. Okay, how about in? We have 100 mole propane in, 600 mole oxygen, 2,256 mole of CO2. That's that. Entropy of propane inlet equal to zero because it reference to inlet, the same condition. But then we feed at 25 and 118, and also reference to feed. Okay, we zero. How about output propane? There is no output. That's right. No output propane. The next oxygen. Oxygen inlet entropy S2, entropy S3, because inlet is 300 Celsius. That's right, 300 Celsius. And also for this case, we assume the entropy is independent of pressure. That's right, independent of pressure. We did not consider the pressure of inlet and outlet. Okay, this S2 and S3 for oxygen and nitrogen. And also output. That's right. Oxygen, nitrogen output, we state by S4 and S5. The output at 1,000 Celsius. That's right. 1,000 Celsius. S4, S5. And the next one, CO2 and water. There is no inlet CO2, no mass and no energy inlet. But we have outlet, three inlet, four inlet, at six, at seven. So now you have to estimate H2 until H7. H2 is oxygen inlet. H3 is nitrogen inlet. H4, oxygen outlet. H5, nitrogen outlet. H6, H7 is CO2 and water outlet respectively. Okay, the next step, we have to evaluate this enthalpy. Okay. Okay, the next step, we have to calculate S2. What is S2? S2 is enthalpy of oxygen at 300 Celsius. H3 is nitrogen at 300 Celsius. This is 1000 Celsius. Okay, for the oxygen and nitrogen, you can open from table BS. I did not show you before, I showed you in the last week. From table BS. This is the entropy for oxygen at 25 Celsius to 300 Celsius. This is the reference to 25 Celsius 188. You can open from 2BF. It's equal to S.47. S.47. And also the same, S.47. You can open for nitrogen at 300 Celsius from 2BF. Nitrogen at 1000 Celsius at table BS, nitrogen at table BS, CO2 at table BS, water also at table BS. That's right. All of this you can open from table BS, H3, H4, H5, H6. That's right, H4, H5, H6. But for water, that's right, water is different. Before from the table BS, the water is different to gas phase. But in this system, we convert water from liquid phase. Right. We refer to water at liquid phase. Okay, that means H7 is water gas phase at 1000, referring to liquid phase at 25 Celsius. Liquid phase at 25 Celsius. Okay, for this case, you have to check from, so I will write something like this. Water. Liquid 25 Celsius to water liquid at 100 Celsius. That's right. And water gas phase at 100 Celsius and water vapor phase at 1000. We have three steps. That's right. We have three steps. Water from reference state at 25 Celsius in liquid phase to water liquid phase at 100 Celsius. Because 100 Celsius is the boiling point or evaporation of water. 100 Celsius. And then you change the phase from liquid to vapor as constant temperature. And then from 100 to 1000. The same technique that we talk about the energy that's related to non-liquid system. It's only the temperature change and phase change. Finally, you get from 25 to 100 is Cp dT of water. The rate of vaporization of water at 100 Celsius. And indicate from 1 to 1000 Cp dT. That's right. 1, 2, 3. That's right. 3 energy. Okay, finally, you get H7 like this. Right, H7. Okay, and now you know H2 until H7. And then you use the formula to calculate for the energy balance for delta S. That's right. For this case, if we have only one reaction, delta S equal to octane of reaction multiplied delta S of reaction. You know delta S of reaction at the standard state. At the standard state. And then you use the technique, the same as non-reactive system. This is non-reactive system. Like this, for reactive system, we have this term. If you remember like that, for non-reactive, we have no this. But for reactive, we have this. This is the same technique that we talk about the non-reactive system. this for single reaction. If it's multiple reaction, you add summation like this. Extent of reaction, delta S of reaction. Okay. Now you substitute extent of reaction, delta S of reaction, you know already. This is extent of reaction. This is delta S of reaction. Right. And then you sum of the product, something like this. This is the outlet, and outlet. You know N, you know S, you know N, you know S. This is H2, H3, H4, 5, 6, 7. Right. You substitute to this. You get delta S equal to minus 1.26 multiplied 10 to the power 5 kilojoules per second. And also you know delta S, you can use the energy balance equation that we derived already at the earlier of the slide, earlier of the lecture for the energy balance. For the open system, we use like this. The heat input minus work output equal to delta S plus delta EK plus delta EP. You know delta S. You check your system, FQ, FW, FEK, or FEP or not. This is the first technique. Again, when you use the energy balance for the reactive system, if you use the heat of reaction technique, you calculate delta S by this formula. That's right, by this formula. Delta S equal to extent of reaction multiply delta S of reaction at standard state. Again, this is at standard state. That's right, at standard state. And then plus the energy or delta S for non-reactive system. This is the reactive. This is non-reactive. That's right. Non-reactive is also the entropy for pressure change, entropy for temperature change, entropy for phase change. That's right. This I talked to you already. If we have multiple reactions, you only summation of extent reaction and delta S of reaction as a step for each reaction. And then you follow the step, the same as the previous. Okay, for the second technique, you can use the heat of formation method. You can use the heat of formation method. We will look the same example. Like we look this the same, everything the same. But for this case, we will apply the heat of formation method, not heat of reaction method. Like the same technique. The first, you have to calculate the energy mass balance. You have to check the mass is balanced or not. And then you choose the reference state for the entropy calculation. For this case, it different from the heat of reaction technique. For heat of formation technique, the reference state should be atomic. That's right. You should reference to the atom. You reference to carbon atom, hydrogen atom. But hydrogen atom mostly we reference to hydrogen gas, oxygen gas, that's right, or sulfur atom, something like this. For the For this case, you have to reference to elemental, that's right, not species, except for hydrogen atom, oxygen atom. Sometimes we find this monoatomic gas, something like this. For carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Okay, for this case, you reference to 25 Celsius. Okay. Again, when you talk about the heat of formation technique, the reference state should be elemental, that's right, not species, except hydrogen, oxygen, or monoatomic gas. Monoatomic gas means gas that include only one atom. That's right. Gas oxygen, only oxygen. That's right. Gas hydrogen is only hydrogen. Something like this. Okay. If, for example, you write the next step, you prepare the table. That's right, for the table. For this case, it's the same. That's right. Propane, oxygen, nitrogen, CO2, water. You know, mass inlet, you know, mass outlet. But for this case, we reference to atom. That's right. We have carbon, hydrogen, and we have carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. We have four atom. That's right. We have four atom. But for this case, we have to reference to four of this atom. To reference to carbon atom. Reference to hydrogen atom. But for this case, we reference to gas hydrogen. Oxygen atom, we reference to gas oxygen. Nitrogen atom with reference to nitrogen, something like this. Yeah, this is the reference state, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen. But good luck for hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen, we have some data in table BA. That's right. It's the same, but not for carbon. That's right, not for carbon. Okay. This is the entropy. That's right. This is not zero. From previous technique, we set up the entropy of propane is zero because we reference to the feed. That's right, the feed is zero, but not for this. I will check. Right. This is zero. Right, because we reference to the feed is zero, but not for this technique. Because this technique we reference to carbon atom. That's right, we're to carbon atom, not propane. And also the technique we calculate the energy for this case, we know right, the mass is balanced already. Mass is balanced already. Okay. All right. For we have S1 to S7. The S1 to S7. S1, you can tell it based on heat information, but S2, S3, S4, 5, 6, 7, you can use the table BA to calculate. Okay, next we consider S1. That's right, for this case, we reference to carbon atom. For carbon atom and hydrogen atom, C3SS, 25 Celsius, 188. We reference to carbon. At 25 Celsius, 1 atm, hydrogen 25 Celsius, 1 atm. But for this case, 3 carbon, 4 hydrogen. That's right, 3 carbon, 4 hydrogen. What is this? This is the heat of formation of C3S8. You can open from table B1 directly. That's right. You can open from table B1 directly. Okay, this is the heat of formation of propane at reference state. That's like at 25 Celsius. Okay, S1 you know already. That's like S1 you know already. If we talk another, if the propane enter at temperature other than 25 Celsius, how we do like this? For example, it's not 25 for the next step. C3SS, maybe 60, sorry. The next step, C3SS at 60 Celsius, that's right. We have two steps. It should be delta S formation. This is delta S of formation, one, that's right. Two, how about two? For this case, plus, indicate from 25 to 60 CpdT, that's right. For this case, but for this example, it's only 25 Celsius. But if I modify to 60 Celsius, we have two steps, that's right. Heat of formation at 25, and then from 25 to 60, you have to add this term, CpdT, right, CpdT. This is the technique to calculate the S1. How about oxygen at 300 Celsius? Right. Oxygen at 300, this is 300 Celsius. This is 1000. For this case, you can open from double BA directly. That's right, double BA directly. You know, right, S2 oxygen to warm double BA. Right. And S3, S4, S5, S6 also. And S620, that's right, S620. But for S6, and S7. That's like for this case, data 8 data information. That's like for 2000 quantum B8, and then you do this, head out, and then you can use the technique by data 8 equal to summation n out s out minus summation n in s. You use the same equation from the previous technique. Like you use the same equation from the previous technique, but except for this case, entropy is include the heat of formation already. That's like include the heat of formation already from the system. I will talk to you in the next example how to use this technique to calculate the energy balance in detail. Right, we have two examples for the understanding. Like this, I will have two examples. The first example, we talk about the heat of reaction technique. The second example, we talk about the heat of formation technique. Okay, look at the first example, the heat of reaction technique. Okay, for the first example, we will apply the heat of reaction technique to the system of, that's right, we have 100 mole of ammonia per second and 2000 mole of oxygen per second at 25 Celsius. Right, feed two reactors, this is reactor. For this case, reactor is to produce the nitrogen oxide and water. That's right, nitrogen oxide and water, this product. And unreacted oxygen also. We have two products, NO and water. And also the output, we have oxygen for unreacted oxygen. Input at 25 Celsius, output at 300 Celsius. The reactor is continuous at reactor. That means accumulation term is zero. That's right, accumulation term is zero. And for this case, the mass is balanced already. The mass is balanced already. Okay, the question is calculate the less at which heat must be transferred to or from the reactor, Q. That should be positive or negative. That's right. For this case, which heat must be transferred to or from the reactor. That means the heat, calculate the heat value and calculate the direction should be into the system or out the system. That's right. For this case, if you use the equation W delta S plus delta EK plus delta EP. If the sign of Q is positive, that means Q input to the system. If sign of the Q is negative, Q should be removed from the system. It depends on the size of the Q, right? Okay. The first step, you draw the diagram already. The basin should be inlet or outlet because you know the amount already. That's right. And the mass is balanced. The second step, make the energy balance and contract the table. That's right. The energy table and also choose the reference state. For this case, we have ammonia gas, oxygen, water, and oxide. If we use the heat of reaction technique, that's right, heat of reaction technique. Okay. We have ammonia, oxygen, nitrogen oxide, and water. That's right, water. For this case, we don't know the data of ammonia. That's right. We don't know the data of ammonia. Okay, you have to shoot the reference state at input or output. For this case, we shoot the input at reference state. We shoot ammonia gas at 25 and 180 hit the feed at the reference state. And how about oxygen? Oxygen, we shoot the 25 and 180. You can shoot the table BS, that's right, table BS for oxygen. Oxygen at table BS is also 25 Celsius and 180. And NO, that's right. NO, we shoot the feed. Sorry, okay. NO. Okay, we have no data also for it. That's right. Okay, for this case, we reference to 25 and 188. And water, we reference to 25 and 188. Table BS also for water. Right. And these are current BS also. Okay. And then you calculate the entropy of ammonia because it's zero, because we reference to the feed. Oxygen, we reference to 25 Celsius and 188 also because This is 25. Input also 25 Celsius. That's that. The same reference. The reference state is 25. And the feed is also 25. That means entropy equal to zero. Again, for ammonia, it reference to the feed. But oxygen is reference to table BS. But table BS, the reference state is also 25 Celsius, which is the same feed. Then we get entropy equal to zero. And oxygen outlet is not 25, outlet at 300 Celsius. That's right, 300 Celsius. 300 Celsius for that case. You can open from table BS directly. You get this value. And then NO at 300 Celsius. We reference to 25 Celsius. That means it's also equal to integrate from 25 to 300 CpNOdT. You open Cp from table B2. You can integrate and substitute for no value. You get S2. That's right. And the last one, water. For water, you reference to table B8 at 25 Celsius and 180. You can open directly from table B. That's right. From table B8. Now you know S1, S2, S3. And then you calculate delta S equal to extent of reaction delta S at the last state. That's right. That summation of N in S in minus or N out minus summation N in S in. Right. That is equation. You know delta S of reaction. You can calculate extent of reaction. Extent of reaction. You write the ammonia. Ammonia equal to 100 because outlet ammonia is zero. Because ammonia is complete reaction. Inlet may not outlet. That's right. Inlet may not outlet divided by the stoichiometry. Inlet is 1000, outlet is zero. You get 100 divided by 4. You get 25 more per second. This is extent of reaction. Okay, now you know extent of reaction. You know the heat of reaction. This is the heat of reaction. It's a heat of reaction. Okay. Extent of reaction, heat of reaction. And out, for this case, 25 multiply S1 plus 100 multiply S2, 150 multiply S3, minus zero, minus zero. Okay. Inlet, outlet, and inlet. You get minus 19,700 kilojoules per second. This is delta S based on heat operation technique. Based on heat operation technique. And then you record the energy balance for open system, The work, we have no data or we have no moving part. We have no electrical field. Right? We have no reactor. It gets at the work is equal to zero. That's right. For this case, we lie in the horizontal, that's right, location, and there is no the reference between inlet and outlet in location. You can neglect EP. And also we neglect the kinetic energy. You get Q equal to delta S. That's right. The heat rate is 19,700 kilowatt. The heat direction is system to the surrounding. That's right, because it's negative. Negative means the heat removed from the system. That's right. That means the heat transfer from the reactor to the temperature. Assigned to the temperature. This is the conclusion about this example. Okay, again, this is the technique to calculate the energy balance based on heat of reaction. For this case, you have to know the extent of reaction. You have to know the heat of reaction as a state. And then you calculate the delta S based on the non-liquid system. Temperature change, phase change, or pressure change. Assigned. Okay. For the next example, we talk about the heat of formation technique. Commonly, heat of formation technique is should be the best for the multiple reaction. Sorry, for a single reaction, it's best for the heat operation technique. But for heat of formation, the easy way is heat of formation, it's for multiple reactions. But don't worry, you can do both heat operation or heat of formation for single or multiple. That's right. But I recommend, if the single reaction, okay, we recommend the heat of reaction technique. But for multiple reaction, I recommend heat of formation technique. Okay, for the second example, we give you example for the energy balance with reactive system, and we will use the heat of formation technique. For this example, methane is oxidized with air to produce formaldehyde in a continuous reactor, but that means that it's dead. That's like no accumulation. We have two combustion equation, methane with oxygen, we get this. And methane with two oxygen, we get CO2 and water. We feed 100 mole on at 25 Celsius. But for this case, we neglect the pressure dependent. That's right, pressure dependent. And air, we feed at 100 Celsius air. That's right, include 100 mole oxygen and 326 mole nitrogen. This is the outlet. We have methane, we have formaldehyde, carbon, water, oxygen, nitrogen. For this case, we have all compound. That means no complete reaction of methane. We have the methane and the air. We have the product formaldehyde, we have product CO2, we have product water, and the air oxygen and the air nitrogen. The outlet is 150 Celsius. 50 Celsius. Also, for this case, we have to calculate the energy, have to calculate the heat. The flowchart is only work and math is only balanced already. That's right. Again, for the heat of formation, we have to reference to atom. For this case, we have how many atom? We have carbon atom. We have hydrogen atom in terms of gas hydrogen. We have oxygen in terms of gas oxygen. And CSO, okay, we have only nitrogen also. Okay. We have four atoms, carbon atom, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, but hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen. We reference to gas hydrogen, oxygen, and gas nitrogen. Okay, the reference state should be atom carbon, atom oxygen in terms of gas oxygen, atom hydrogen in terms of gas hydrogen, atom of nitrogen in terms of gas nitrogen at standard state 25 Celsius 180. And then you read the possible enthalpy. Methane, S1, inlet, S4 outlet. Inlet, S4 outlet. Inlet at 25 Celsius, reference to 25 Celsius 180. This is the species methane, reference to carbon, reference to hydrogen. That's right. It's not zero. Because it is not zero. It's 25 also. It's 25 also, but it's not zero. Because this is compound methane, reference to carbon atom, reference to hydrogen atom. It's not zero. Okay. Oxygen, S2 and S5 outlet. Nitrogen, S3 inlet, S6 outlet. Formaldehyde, no inlet. We have S7 outlet. CO2, no inlet outlet, S8, and water, no inlet, S9 outlet. That's right, S9 outlet. For oxygen, nitrogen, CO2, and water, you can open from table B8. That's right, you can open table B8 because it's reference state, it's also the same. Okay, look at each term. The first one, methane at 25 Celsius, it's the phase methane, it's S1. Right, because it's reference to carbon and hydrogen at 25 Celsius. That's right, the same temperature, but reference to carbon and hydrogen. This is mean heat of formation of methane. That's right, as I talk to you, because it's reference to 25 Celsius to carbon atom to hydrogen atom. This is heat of formation. You can open from table B2. That's right, it will be two. Again, if we reference, it's different for methane. for S4. For S4, this is 150, not 25. That's right. 150, not 25. How to do this? You have to write for this case. Right? This means carbon 25 plus hydrogen 25 to be CH4 at 25. Right, and then CH4 at 150. All right. This is heat of formation, delta HF. This is delta S from CPDT. That's right, CPDT. We have two steps from carbon and hydrogen to produce methane at 25 Celsius. We did the standard state. And then from 25 to 100. Right, for this case, we mix between heat of formation and heat based on temperature change. Okay, for this case, heat of formation plus indicate from 25 to 150 CPDT. Okay, this is H4. Okay, H2 is oxygen at 100 Celsius. Oxygen at 100 Celsius. For this case, you can open from turbo BS directly because we reference to 25. And ST, nitrogen, also open from turbo BS. Because we reference to 25 also. The next one, right? Oxygen H5. Oxygen H5 at 150, you can open from turbo BS. Nitrogen, you can open from turbo BS. Because at turbo BS, we reference to 25 Celsius already. The next one is formaldehyde at 150. This is also the same. Okay, I will show you. Formaldehyde. It form hydrogen at 25 Celsius plus carbon is hydrogen at 25 Celsius plus oxygen should be 1.5 oxygen 25 Celsius to HCSO 25 and then to HCSO at 150. That's right. Delta S1 is heat of formation. Delta S2 is of the temperature change. So we have two steps. From this is hydrogen, carbon, and a half of oxygen produced formaldehyde. This is heat of formation. S1, heat of formation. S2 is indicate CPDT from 25 to 150. You get like this. Okay. And CO2, that's right. CO2 also the same. That's right. CO2 also the same. Formaldehyde, from carbon, but oxygen. That's right. This is 25 Celsius and 25 Celsius to 150. For 150, you can indicate CPDT or you can open from turbo BS. That's right. You can open from turbo BS or you can indicate CPDT. And the last one, water, vapor phase. Water at 25 is the heat of formation. And indicate from 25 to 150. You can indicate or you can open from turbo BS also. Okay, now you know our entropy, right? S1 to S9. You substitute to the equation. That's right. You know of this. And then we substitute to this equation. Delta S equal to summation in out, S out minus in S in. That's right. Okay. Our is this summation of this minus summation of this. You get minus 15,300 kilojoule. That's right, 300 kilojoule. But for you can see that for the heat of formation, you not necessary to use the heat of reaction or exchange of reaction. Why? Because we include the heat of reaction in term of S in and S out already. Right? Did we include heat of formation already? That's right. We include heat of formation already. That means S1 S4, S7, S8, S9 input heat of reaction in terms of heat of formation already in the equation. That means you're not necessary to use the heat of reaction, right? When you consider like this technique. Like this technique, you have to calculate this. But for heat of formation, not necessary. Because heat of reaction input in enthalpy of each term already. Okay, and then you consider like the general equation. That's that. For this case, we have no work, no kinetic, no potential. We get Q equal to delta S. And also for this case, you get negative, right? That means heat removed from the system to the surrounding. That's right. Heat removed from the system to the surrounding. Okay, we will stop for today. And I will talk more example for the heat operation, including the energy balance.